Our parasha, Emor el Kohanim b'nei Aharon, speaks about the Jewish priest, the Kohen, and his character. One of the interesting texts that define the Kohen can be found in Masechet Avot, the Ethics of the Fathers. There it says, Hevei mitamidav shel Aharon, be one of the disciples of Aharon. Aharon is Moses' brother, the first Kohen Gadol. Ohev shalom v'rodef shalom, love peace and chase after peace. Go always try to find peace. Shalom. Ohev et abriot u'mekarvan la'Torah. Love the creatures, the people, and get them closer to the Torah. The first component, ohev shalom v'rodef shalom. If you love shalom, asks the Maharal, one of the commentators over this passage, if you love shalom, why do you need to chase after it? You love it, you live it. And he answers, sometimes it's not enough to just like shalom and to be a person of shalom and peace, because life has its ways, its ups and downs, and conflicts are part of life. Whether in every circle, especially with your spouse, if even though that you might not be the person that are responsible or that did not initiate this conflict, do not wait for your partner to come over and try to fix it, to bring shalom back, even though he might or she might be the one to blame for this. In couple's life, in shalom life, we do not seek for who is guilty, who is responsible, who is to blame for this and that, or in our case, of the conflict. You always be the one to try to chase after the shalom. You might have been the person of shalom. Do not initiate or start any conflict, but don't wait for him or her to try to solve it. The happiest you will be if you always be the one to chase after the shalom. Bezat Hashem, also your spouse will be the same, and the life will be life, but eventually of shalom. The second component, ohev et abriot u'mekarvan la'Torah, love the creatures, love your, in this case, your partner, your spouse. Sometimes, again, as life goes and there are changes in life, one of the spouses, one of the couples are strengthening more in life of Torah and mitzvot and want to increase these values, enhance his religious aspect of life. You love your spouse, your partner, regardless to his or her religiosity. This is not the reason why you came together. Now, still, because you realize and want this aspect of life, of the religious life, observant life maybe, and you see how good it is, and you want to share it with your partner, this is very good. The way to introduce him or her to more Jewish life, more religious life, is by loving her or him more and more. The second, why do I say that? First it says, first love your partner, and only then by that, if they see how good it is individually, as a couple, as a family life, in a community, then by themselves they will already get closer to Jewish life. But first we start with not only but as means to mikarvana Torah, by as end it is important to love the briot. Ohev shalom v'rodev shalom. Ehovet abriot u'mekarvan la'Torah, git Shabbos.